Thank you. I'm a professor of musicology at the Faculty of Music at Laval University in Quebec City. When I started learning the piano at the age of 14, I discovered the Transcendental Studies by Liszt. In a version by Louis Kentner, the British pianist of Hungarian birth. And I was so fascinated that I listened to his recordings until the time I could listen to the two sides at the same time. So I've been with piano virtuosity during all those years, and progressively I discovered the music of Busoni, Alkan, Godowsky, Granger, Ronald Stevenson, and Sarabji. And all those people are part of what I've called the Busoni network. They're all major figures in the history of piano playing and piano music, pianist composers or composer pianists, who wrote large-scale works that, for lots of reasons, have remained rather obscure or neglected by most of the music world. But these composers now are attracting increasing attention. There has been a real revival in their work. Some pianists have made a very significant contribution toward this rediscovery. And one of them is Marc-André Hamelin, whose recital I attended yesterday at the Domaine Forgette. Thank you. Experiencing live music is always fascinating. We have the artist in front of us who is delivering his message. And we see his intelligence, his musical feeling at work. And what always strikes me when I attend a recital by Mark is how deeply involved in music making he is. He is totally absorbed in what he does. He doesn't lose a second with superfluous gestures aimed at pleasing an audience. He's totally involved in what he does. His concentration is absolutely intense. It's quite remarkable that he is able to sustain such a high concentration. And the works he plays are extremely demanding most of the time. And there's hardly a tradition behind him. Thank you. Well, I've known these studies for some 30 years. I had these scores on my piano stand several years before recordings were available. And I've always been fascinated with this music, because Chopin's music is rather linear, like a lot of the music of the 1830s. But Gadowski turned the Chopin studies into highly involved polyphonic music. Basically, his idea was that one could take the right hand of the original and trust it to the left hand, and then add above that new counterpoint. And his thinking was almost exclusively polyphonic. He developed the polydynamic, polyrhythmic, and polyphonic possibilities of the keyboard to an unheard of degrees. And this is what makes his music so fascinating. There's never any shallow, empty virtuosity, the kind of which we encounter so often in second-rate 19th century composers. His music is always very carefully laid out, always meant to provide a very developed image. He never tries to impress with gimmickry or tricks.
Thank you.
even listening to a piano transcription, a rather strict piano transcription of a Beethoven symphony. Well, they are rather anonymous arrangements by little-known arrangers of the 19th century. But when you take the so-called partition de piano that Liszt wrote of Beethoven's symphonies, he really translates the music. He's not a slave trying to translate word for word what Beethoven wrote. He's trying to grasp the original and render it in the terms of the instrument that he's using. Just like a translator who absorbs a poem and then uses all the resources of the host language to render it for another audience. There is so much to be discovered in that repertoire of transcriptions to which so many composers devoted so much time.
Thank you. Thank you.